Hey guys, Brian Owens here, the Uber and Lyft driver with ThePro.Drivers.com. Before I get started, if you would like to receive any future notifications about my videos or information about these videos, please be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell in the right-hand corner. That way you get notifications as soon as possible. Also, in the description below, you will find a couple of links there, two of them particularly being for Lyft and Uber to sign up to become a driver if you would like to be. And also for the riders, there's also links as well to potentially get a free or discounted ride. And as well as there are links to the website for merchandise and stuff like that that could potentially help you out on your rideshare journey. So if you do like any of my videos, please be sure to hit the like icon, so that way it'd definitely support the channel and these videos will get better ratings on YouTube. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into this. Today we're going to talk about five particular types of topics, and that are the five things that I feel can get you permanently deactivated from Uber or Lyft. Number one is definitely reckless driving. And yeah, reckless driving. Most people don't think that's really an issue, but it is. I've actually taken it as a passenger quite a few times, and people drive recklessly. What they don't know is what they're doing is endangering people's lives. So all that person has to do is literally call the cops and have them meet them at their address and have that person arrested for endangerment. I don't think they really know that. You should be on your P's and Q's at all time and make sure you get your passengers there safely. That is the most important reason as to why we do this. That's what we're here for, is to get people from point A to point B safely. And number two would probably be sexual harassment. And no, I'm not talking about full-blown sexual harassment in a sense as to like, hey, you know, you look good tonight type stuff. No, I'm referring to just the common little minute things as into asking somebody for their number as they're getting out of car. That can be taken really, really wrong, be really, really creepy. You know, you're dropping them off in front of their house potentially, and you're asking for their number. Keep it professional. This is a business. This is your business, technically. You are 1099. You're subcontracted. Let's keep it that way. That's the way it should be, 100%. Now, if somebody asks you for your number and you're the driver, you can do what you want to do. But I don't recommend asking them for anything. You know, be nice, be courteous the entire time. Say a couple of jokes here and there, but do not make people feel uncomfortable in any type of way. Can be taken completely wrong. And number three, I'd have to say number three would probably be the underage minor situation. And car seats. This ties them both up. I'm going to go ahead and nail both of them into number three. Taking an underage minor without the being accompanied by an adult can get you in some serious legal action. Not only are you not supposed to take it according to Uber and Lyft, they will terminate you immediately once they find out, but if something happens, they can get you for child endangerment. And that is a charge you do not want to have to face. I do not know if it is an arrestable offense on site. I'm not a lawyer by any means whatsoever, but there is some serious legal action that can be taken on behalf of the parents that you took, even if they gave you permission. As they like to call it, oh, it's okay, I'm giving you permission to take my child. Screw that and screw them. The other thing is car seats. Car seats. This is still part of number three, though. The car seat thing, I don't understand the concept of why people would even try to bring their children with no car seats. It baffles me. I don't recommend carrying any car seats of any kind whatsoever. Because it's not your responsibility. It's the parent's responsibility. And if you are going to carry any form of car seat, I recommend the booster seats and booster seats only. They do not require any special weight, sizes, heights, or anything like that for those seats. There's no extra requirements for them. You get into the actual car seat side of things, there's tons of requirements. You get rear facing, front facing, and it's just so much to keep up with. You put a child in a that's supposed to be in a rear-facing car seat and a front-facing car seat, and something happens, again, more legal stipulations. So, definitely, I wouldn't even fool with it. They don't have car seats, collect your five, and drive. Simple. It's not that difficult. With Lyft, wait your five, call, then drive. And I think I said the first one wrong. Wait five, collect, and drive is the proper terminology for it. And then I think the number four on the list would definitely have to be, I would say, lethal or non-lethal forms of protection. And the only reason I would say that is because it's against Uber and Lyft's terms of agreement. If somebody happens to see it, I'm not saying don't carry if that's what makes you feel comfortable as a driver. I'm not saying that at all. And I'm not saying do carry it either. I'm saying be mindful of the fact that you are carrying. If somebody happens to see it and they feel any type of way and report you, you'll be automatically terminated. And that goes for lethal or non-lethal, if I remember correctly. Correct me if I'm wrong on the non-lethal, please, but I'm pretty sure it goes for non-lethal as well, referring to tasers and stun guns and stuff like that. But please correct me if I'm wrong on that. And then there is the final one. And the final one would probably have to be, I'd have to say, I think it's app manipulation. I think that was the one I was going to go with. Yes, app manipulation and cash rides. App manipulation meaning, with Uber, you get to where you're close to the trip, close enough to hit I've arrived. And right as soon as you do, you see they're going a block away. You don't want that trip. You want a longer trip. You don't want to go down the street for, I think it's $5 for a Lyft. I think it's $3.75 for an Uber. I don't know. I'm not sure on the base prices myself. That's for regular Lyft and Uber. I do XL and up only. So the base prices, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's $3.75 for Uber though. And you cancel before the 5 minutes is even up. Well, that's app manipulation. It's called poor passenger experience is the term that Lyft uses. And they will deactivate you for that. They do not like that. If you cancel beforehand, they still don't like it, but it's not as bad as you showing up and hit I've arrived. You'll still get the poor passenger experience aspect if you cancel before that. And the other thing with that, I'm tying these two together again for number five, taking cash rides. Everybody wants to, because you get 100% of the profit. It's very tempting, but there's so many risks involved in that. One, if you take a cash ride, something was to happen, somebody was to get into a wreck, you have to cover their injuries through your personal insurance. They will drop you once they found out that you did this. You will lose your insurance and could potentially get charges pressed against you again for taking rides outside of a proper app that is actually certified to be able to do that type of thing. I'm not sure if that stipulation really is in here in Georgia. But I know those are similar situations. I think it goes for the whole hailing a ride fare type thing. I think it falls underneath that class in some weird way. So your best bet is to stick with the app, run it through the app. At least that's what I do. Even for my personal rides, I've made videos about having private clients and stuff like that. All my private clients are ran through the app. One, for insurance purposes. Uber and Lyft have million-dollar policies. I would much rather somebody be taken care of properly and get all their medical bills taken care of through their million-dollar policy than through my personal insurance. That million-dollar policy is going to make sure everything's covered. My personal insurance, you might get lucky to get a Band-Aid. No, I'm just joking. I got decent insurance, so. But still, I would much rather it not go on my personal insurance, because one, if they cancel me off my personal insurance, I got to go find more insurance. And two, that's just a pain in the ass. It really is. So that would probably be the five things I would definitely say would get you deactivated. You got reckless driving, sexual harassment, underage minors, and no car seats. Lethal or non-lethal forms of protection. Again, let me know if the non-lethal part is true or not. It's been a while since I looked at the guidelines on that. And also app and cash manipulation. It's still manipulating if you take a cash ride. You manipulated them outside the app. So let me know y'all's thoughts on process and, you know, processes and all that stuff after you think about all this stuff, this information I'm giving you. Let me know what y'all think. Definitely would love to hear your feedback, riders and passengers alike. Just let me know. Shoot a message in the video below, and I'm going to let y'all get back to enjoying y'all's Friday and Saturday night, and y'all have a good night. Uber and Lyft Driver out. Catch y'all next time. Stay safe out there.